So I know we're always telling you to make sure you're ready for the next big one, but I bet a few of you wish you knew what our own Earth scientists here at GNS are doing. So a few of them decided to show us.
I'm Hannah Brackley, and I'm head of the Tectonophysics Department at GNS Science. I live here in a Wellington City apartment block, where I've been for about 8 years now. When the Sunday afternoon Cook Strait earthquake hit, I was actually outside, just up at the gate here, about to come into the apartment building. I felt the very strong shaking, so I just stayed up there by the road where I knew I was clear of anything that might fall or cause any harm. Our building was built in the mid-1960s. It's been rated by Wellington City Council as 69% of the current new building standard, so well above their requirements in terms of earthquake strength. If I was to be here in the apartment during a strong earthquake, I would drop cover and hold, and I would, after the shaking has stopped, I would move into the hallway. This is probably the strongest part of the building, the core of the building and the hallway of the apartment here. So once the shaking has stopped, I would leave the apartment and evacuate down the stairwell rather than using the lifts. So I've had the bookshelf secured to the wall in order to prevent it falling in case of an earthquake. The other thing I've done is remove large items that I previously had on the top shelf here. I've taken them down so that they won't fall in an earthquake. My survival kit is still a bit of a work in progress and I haven't yet got any food in it, but I have got quite a well-stocked pantry, so I would hope to be able to call on that. So I have the beginnings of an emergency kit here in my storage cupboard, again in the strongest part of the building, so somewhere that I should be able to access easily enough. I've got a container of water, and in my emergency kit I have some black plastic bags, a rain poncho, a couple of torches, lantern. I've also got a wind up radio torch and mobile phone charger all in one. That's a hand-driven device, some spare batteries, a water bottle. Clearly room for more items to be added, but it's a starting point. I'm on the board of directors for the apartment building, so as a board we decided to develop a disaster plan for the building. The main principle of the plan is that individuals should be prepared themselves. They should have their emergency kit and an individual plan for case of an emergency. But if there was to be a large earthquake or any other emergency, we would work together as a community and support one another. So I think most Wellingtonians know that we could well have a large earthquake or a number of earthquakes here in our city, and it is our responsibility to individually be prepared. And living in an apartment building like this, we also are a small community, and together we need to be prepared and support one another. So having the disaster plan for our building is an action we've taken to try and be prepared for such a situation.